Today we hosted the our first economic development symposium. Kind of the purpose was to celebrate county business, talk about what's good, the history, maybe try to forecast a little bit what's in the future. Really rolled out and had Steve Pennington from the state here to discuss the enterprise zone we just did at the county, which I think is going to help some redevelopment and maybe spur some businesses coming over here to start doing business in the county. Memo Derricker from Salisbury's Beacon program was the keynote speaker, and he had a wealth of knowledge. It was like a college year and a half hour speech. Talked a little bit about trends and globally, some trends locally, and some trends statewide, and some great info from him. It's always impressive hearing him, and it was fantastic.
Looks like you had a great turnout.
Yeah, it was surprisingly. I believe we had more people than we expected, so we do want to make it an annual event. Specifically, I'd like to do some awards program next year and honor some of the county businesses that are doing great business here. But yeah, we had a great turnout, more than we expected, and great breakfast. I know some connections were made, and maybe some deals will come out of this. So it was good stuff.
So for the past few years, Beacon at Salisbury University has been working with Queen Anne's County, the Economic Development Commission here, looking at the economic landscape. We did a very comprehensive survey of all key stakeholders to get a good feel of what's working, what's not working, what are some of the opportunities, what are some of the challenges, strengths locally, weaknesses locally, to be able to determine strategic direction for the Economic Development Commission, for them to be able to advise the elected officials here in the county. With that in mind, after the survey was done, after the focus groups were done, we convened a series of retreats where we developed the EDC's Economic Development Commission's new vision, new mission, and we developed six driving strategies, three of them short term, two of them medium term, and one long term. And for each of these driving strategies, we help them develop action steps. This is what they're going to do to be able to accomplish what they want to accomplish through these driving strategies. This is what's going to inform them when they are helping our elected officials make decisions about the county's economy.
How do you feel about the overall economy?
Well, I think the overall economy is still suffering, overall, the United States itself. I think we still have a good ways to go. I think this new administration is going to lead us in the right direction. People want to work. Business people want to go out there and create jobs for individuals. You know, people want to make money, and that's the problem that we're having in this country. It's, you know, from 2007, 2008, a lot of companies like myself have learned to do a lot more with a lot less. And that's affecting the economy tremendously. There's not enough people out there making the high dollar jobs. There's not enough people out there working. I think the unemployment rates that we see are really underestimated big time, because there's so many people out there have not even bothered to get a job. Plus they count part-time jobs, and these are individuals still looking for full-time jobs.
How do you feel about Queen Anne's County's economic position or position? Are they positioned well?
Oh, that is a great question. Queen Anne's County is in a unique position in the state of Maryland, being the second largest state in the Maryland, land-wise, but one of the smallest populations. I think we in this county have an advantage, because we can attract the businesses here. You look at the water to surround us. You look at Kent Island. Then you look at the farmland to go out. This is a wonderful place to live, work, and play, obviously. So my goal and the commissioner's goals is to attract businesses here, show them that Queen Anne's County is here to play and we want to be in business. And I think the business climate over the last couple of years has tremendously changed with this administration and prior administrations leading up to this.
I'm Steve Pennington, Managing Director for the Maryland Department of Commerce, here this morning at the Queen Anne's County Economic Development Summit. Today I was speaking about our enterprise zones and how it impacts future economic development for jobs, for growth, retention, and attraction within Queen Anne's County, and how it can have a very positive impact on future development activities.
I think the climate in the county is probably one of the best that it's been in a while. You know, the county administrators and the planning commission and also the county commissioners have been very pro-business. You know, they've been working to streamline the development process, the PERP process, so for good projects to come through. I think the county is on a good growth plan, with good sensible growth. The comp plans, have really facilitated the areas where, development can go. And I think that as more people move over here and we get more rooftops, the opportunities over here for new businesses to start and for, job opportunities for the youth are going to continue to increase. And I think by having more services here, more businesses here on the island or in the county, that's less trips you got to make across the Bay Bridge, which so it really is a benefit.
Making plans is great, but if those plans sit on a shelf, gather dust, it's useless. For a plan to really work, those action steps need to be implemented. And when they're being implemented, you need to know where you are. It's just like when you get on your car, you turn your GPS on and you look at where you are, where you're going, what the path is. And if there's a traffic jam along the way, you make changes. We're creating dashboards for each of these action steps for the driving strategies to be able to inform the decision makers of both the EDC as well as the elected officials as to where the county is on each one of these action steps and therefore where the county is on each one of these six driving strategies, economically speaking. If something is doing well, it can come off of those driving strategies, something else can be brought in. If it's not doing well, if an action step is behind schedule, they will immediately see that and be able to make decisions, take action to bring it back on course. That's what a dashboard does. It helps them visualize the progress on the plan. The dashboard is based on a database that has metrics on each one of those action steps and those driving strategies. It's updated quarterly, and on the basis of those updates, provides not only the new numbers, but also the trend, where we were and where we're going, and also answers a few what-if questions as to where those strategies would take the county if certain action steps are taken.
When we had our last economic development director here, we created something called the Bridge Fund. And the Bridge Fund originally was put together through a resolution to the county commissioners to create new businesses from outside the county to move to this county. And the county would help them with infrastructure. And it was kind of like a point system based on how many people you hire, you know, how you maintain them, how big the facility is going to be. You can apply for this bridge fund, and I think you can qualify up to $750,000 on that fund. And then we have the EDIF fund, which is for local businesses, which is for retention. As anybody in economic development knows, retention is your number one goal in your county, because retention is going to build you jobs. You go out to the guitar place, you go out to some of the hotels, you go out to some of the manufacturers. They're looking to expand their businesses, so they can apply for the EDIF fund, use that money to expand their businesses, create more jobs for people to live in this county and work in this county.
It looks promising.
Absolutely it is. I'll give you an example. We commissioners voted to send a letter out to Samsung, the manufacturing group located out of South Korea. They do have a main office here in the United States in Rutherford, New Jersey. And they announced a month ago that they want to build 7 new manufacturing plants for kitchen appliances. So we dominated on that. I sit on the steering committee for the National Association of Counties, and I heard this, came back to the commissioners, told them about this. We sent out a letter asking for an audience. I put together a coalition of businessmen, Jody Schultz, Barry Waterman, Jim Donadio, myself, and Eric Hoffman. So I'm hoping that we're able to get this audience and go to them and show them that, one, look at Queen Anne's County. It's beautiful, right? Great place to live and work. Two, if we don't have the workforce probably for 7,000 people, but if you put this facility out in, say, Sothersville District 1 area, you're gonna bring people in from Kent County, Talbot County, and Cecil County. So yes, absolutely.
Thanks for your time.
Anytime, thank you.
We've been on the shore for almost 40 years. We're in the land development business and also the construction business and property management. So most of what we do is we build and propose uses that we feel, you know, are needed here. You know, we've done apartments, we've done commercial, retail. All the retail stores that we, you know, that we open or help people open are providing jobs and tax base to the county. Yeah, absolutely. It's been very good. Very, very, very good place to work.
Well, Queen Anne's number one advantage is its location, both in terms of the beautiful nature that surrounds the county, as well as its proximity to the major metropolitan areas. By the same token, that very advantage is also a disadvantage. It creates traffic issues, it creates dependence on the economies of the region. So it's a matter of taking the advantages of the county's location to mitigate the disadvantages of the county's location. It takes real strategic thinking, real strategic planning to be able to do that. And this is why the EDC has created this strategic plan, to be able to exploit the advantages of the county and take precautions about some of the disadvantages of the proximity to the federal government, the proximity to the metro areas in terms of traffic and being dependent on the economy there. There are many, many natural and native advantages of the county that can be exploited. Some of the tourism issues, some of the agricultural opportunities, but also the youth. The county has an aging population at one end, but has the ability to engage the younger population, especially if the younger population and the older population can be brought together so that a knowledge transfer takes place. And the older population is sitting on a lot of financial resources that they have earned during their lives that are currently investing those resources in far-flung corporations around the country and around the world. If some of that money can be brought in and invested in the young people here in terms of business incubation, business acceleration, entrepreneurship, this is the future.
We have meetings once a month with Economic Development Commission. They're open to the public. It's an 11-person board. They're, when we need people, it's solicited through the newspapers, and you can apply and show interest, and then it's appointed by the commissioners. By all means, the meetings are open. So
the best place to find out more about this presentation and the strategic plan is through the Economic Development Commission in Queen Anne's County and Economic Development Office. They have all the data, they have all the survey results, they have all the plan, the action steps, and they are going to be the ones hosting the dashboard. So that's a wonderful resource here in Queen Anne's County.